家好，我是 Stella，
我是 Warren， 我们今天要为您念的是《奇迹正文》第21章，理性与知见 ，Chapter 21，Reason and Perception， 八内在的转变 ，8 the inner shift。
如此说来，思想岂不是万分危险的东西？Are thoughts then dangerous? 对身体而言，确实如此。To bodies, yes. 那好似能够害人的念头一再叮咛着它的主人，它也可能被人伤害。The thoughts that seem to kill are those that teach the thinker that he can be killed.然而他就这样死在自己学来的想法之下 And so he dies because of what he learned 这段由生命通往死亡的过程成了他看重无常胜过恒常的最终证明 He goes from life to death The final proof he valued the inconstant more than consistency他当然认为自己想要幸福 Surely he thought he wanted happiness 但他如此渴望绝不是因为幸福乃是生命恒常不变的真相 Yet he did not desire it because it was the truth and therefore must be constant 喜悦的恒常境界对你极其陌生而难解The constancy of joy is a condition quite alien to your understanding. 但你只需想象一下喜悦必然的美妙，即使无法了解，你也会衷心向往的。Yet, if you could even imagine what it must be, you could desire it, although you understand it not. 幸福的恒常境界没有变数，也无例外。The constancy of happiness has no exceptions, no change of any kind. 正如上主对教化之爱那般千古不易 It is unshakable, as is the love of God of his creation. 幸福的慧见一如造物主的真知一般气力不摇他的眼光只会注目于万物的同一性 Sure in its vision as its creator is in what he knows Happiness looks on everything and sees it is the same 绝不着眼于幻灭之相因他渴望万物效是自己故会待万物如己 It sees not the ephemeral for it desiresEverything be like itself and sees it so. 世间没有任何力量能够打断幸福的恒常性，只因幸福本身具有万夫难当的愿力。Nothing has power to confound its constancy because its own desire cannot be shaken.凡是能看透最后一道问题，乃是其于问题之根的人。必然享有这种幸福，一如决心痊愈而放下评判的人，必然享有平安，是同一道理。It comes as surely unto those who see the final question is necessary to the rest, as peace must come to those who choose to heal and not to judge. 理性会告诉你，你祈求平安时不能一曝十寒 Reason will tell you that you cannot ask of happiness inconstantly 既然你渴望什么就会获得什么而幸福的本质又具恒常性那么你只需祈求一件事就永远拥有它了 For if what you desire you receive and happiness is constant then you need ask for it but once to have it always 如果你并非一直拥有幸福根据上述的逻辑表示你并未真正祈求过幸福 And if you do not have it always being what it is you did not ask for it任何人若相信某样东西能满全自己的心愿，他绝对会去求的。For no one fails to ask for his desire of something he believes holds out some promise of the power of giving it. 也许他会求错东西或找错目标。He may be wrong in what he asks, where and of what. 但他会去求的，因为渴望本身其实一种求，一种愿，而上主是不可能让任何祈求落空的。Yet he will ask because desire is a request.And asking for and made by one whom God himself will never fail to answer. 上主早已赐给他真正需要之物了。God has already given all that he really wants. 但如果连他都不确定自己要什么，上主就爱莫能助了。Yet what he is uncertain of, God cannot given.因他若不确定就不会渴望，缺了接受的一方，上主便无法完成他的馈赠。 For he does not desire it while he remains uncertain, and God's giving must be incomplete unless it is received. 你正是帮上主完成旨意的人，你正是他的喜悦，你的意愿就如同他的旨意一般有力，这一愿力绝不会因为身在幻境而失去效力的。你不妨深思一下，自己为何始终下不了决心来答复最后一道问题。You who complete God's will and are His happiness, whose will is powerful as His, a powerful that is not lost in your illusions.Think carefully why you have not yet decided how you would answer the final question. 你对前面三个问题的答复已经帮你的神智恢复了部分的清明。Your answer to the others has made it possible to help you be already partly seen.最后一道问题不过是在问你是否愿意全面恢复神智的清明而已。 And yet it is the final one that really asks if you are willing to be wholly seen. 神圣的一刻其实只是上主请你认清他说是你的一切恩典而已。 What is the holy instant but God's appeal to you to recognize what he has given you?他要你绝于那不曾离开你一步的真相，以及随时都非你莫属的幸福，这对理性具有莫大的吸引力。Here is the great appeal to reason, the awareness of what is always there to see, the happiness that could be always yours. 唯有在此，你才可能时时感受到永恒的平安。Here is the constant peace you could experience.Forever, 唯有在此，你才会再度看见那一度被你自己排拒之物。Here is what denial has denied, revealed to you. 最后一道问题终于在此得到了答复，你也喜获自己祈求之物。For here the final question is already answered, and what you ask for given.未来就在当下，这一刻时间已失去它的作用，只因你已开始渴望恒长不变至今。 Here is the future now, for time is powerless because of your desire for what will never change. 你由衷盼望没有一物能横亘在自己所有关系当中而使你意识不到它的神圣性。 For you have asked thatNothing stands between the holiness of your relationship and your awareness of its holiness.
第二十一章，理性与知见 ，Chapter 21 Reason and Perception. 八内在的转变 ，8 the inner shift. 愿大家。有一个生命充满的一天，阿门，我爱你。